lovers, and welcome to another one of Mark's Whiskey Ramblings. And look what the cat dragged in, my brother in arms, my partner in crime, Manny. That means it's time for Mark and Manny's Malts. Yes, we are here to introduce to you the fourth and final release in the so-called Antarctica Series. Now, you know that for the Antarctica Series, we were able to use pictures that were taken by the Flemish photographer Ilse Everaert, who traveled there, and she allowed us to use four fantastic images on our bottles. We're very happy with that. But before we tell you anything more about the fourth and final release in the Antarctica Series, I think it's time for you to meet the photographer extraordinaire. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ilse Everaert.
Hello.
Ilse, welcome, welcome. So, it's your pictures on our labels. Yep. We're very happy with that. But maybe you could tell the viewers of Mark and Manny's Malts a little bit about your adventures.
Okay. First of all, thank you, Mark and Manny, for the opportunity to have my pictures on a whiskey bottle. As a whiskey lover myself, it's nice to see those pictures on a whiskey label. I hope you enjoyed all the pictures on the whiskey label. I know you're whiskey lovers, but still, they are nice pictures to show. And if you love them on the bottle, maybe you love them in a photo book as well. I love traveling and I love going to places where distilleries are. Unfortunately, I have a lot of time to go to a distillery, but magic places to have pictures taken. You have beautiful light, blue, the sun is almost always out, and the white of the eyes. So enjoy the book that is coming soon with 30 of my extraordinary pictures.
That's great stuff. We are definitely going to want this.
Yep.
But what we would like to say is a big thank you to Ilse for allowing us to use these pictures.
Yes.
Let's give us a big hug. Anyway, that was Ilse Everaert. So be on the lookout for her Antarctica book, which is coming soon.
Yeah.
So I'll just put that right there.
We are very lucky to have her.
Absolutely. Stunning pictures. Stunning pictures. Yeah. And we've had a preview of the book that is upcoming. The pictures in there are absolutely amazing. But right, back to the whiskey at hand.
Yeah.
So the fourth and final release. Well, it's a special one.
It is.
We're very, very, very happy to be able to present this one to you, because this, ladies and gentlemen, is a sherry cask matured, 15 years old.
Yay!
Orkney malt. It's an Orkney malt.
Orkney.
Oh my god.
My favorite distillery.
Yeah, no.
Which
no,
we cannot
no, no,
discuss.
No, it's an Orkney malt. And the funny thing is, on the label you will see it's a dramatic iceberg, right?
Yeah.
And this is in the Weddell Sea. Now, the Weddell Sea is named after James Weddell, a Scottish sailor, actually born in Belgium.
Belgium.
In Belgium, in Ostend. In 18, I don't know, 17 something.
17, who cares? Century or
anyway, he entered this Weddell Sea in 1823. He was a seal hunter. There you have it.
Yep.
And, well, the Weddell Sea that you see here is actually, it surrounds the South Orkney Islands.
Yep.
How about that? The South Orkney Islands. So very, very, very well thought of to use that picture on this label, because it's an Orkney malt. Obviously, the South Orkney Islands in Antarctica have little, if nothing, to do with the Orkney Islands in the northern British Isles, because then you have the northern Scottish Isles, there you have Orkney. It's about 70 islands, of which 20 are inhabited.
So something like that. Yeah.
And then Orkney itself is often referred to as the mainland, and the government is in Kirkwall, just dropping a few hints there. But anyway, we are not at liberty to tell you what this malt, from which distillery it's from. Now, there's two distilleries in Orkney, right?
Yeah.
You have Scapa, and you have Highland Park.
Right.
So, there you have. So, it's one of these two, right?
Pick your pick.
Yeah, take your pick. It's, it's not Scapa. There.
Nope.
Is it Highland Park? We can neither confirm nor deny.
Nope.
Right? Okay, so let's just leave it at that. But we have selected for you a 15-year-old beautiful malt, which you will find that it bursts with fruit, but it still remains very close to the distillery character.
Right.
So there you have it. This is the type of malt that would even, you know, set the heart of a Viking aflame. Let's give this one a go.
Yes.
Sherry cask at last. 53.2% ABV.
Mm.
There you go, my friend. This should make you very, very happy.
I am.
To be honest, we were somewhat very happily surprised when we stumbled upon this cask and got the opportunity to get it.
Well, I was trying to get this one since the beginning.
Oh, for the longest time.
Because
for the longest time,
begging and
even sexual favors. No.
Oh yeah, I did those two.
Yeah, those two. No, just kidding. Sorry. Just kidding. But anyway, it's a very hard to come by whiskey. So,
yeah.
3 years in the making, this release,
yeah.
And finally at the third year of Mark and Manny's Malts for our fourth release,
yeah.
We have been able to score this Orkney malt. So, like we said, sherry cask, 53.2% ABV. A beautiful, full golden color.
It is. Yeah.
Oh, are you ready?
I am ready.
Let's do this on the nose.
Oh yeah.
I can see
the signatory.
Yeah. This is the distillery character on it.
Yeah.
You will be able to recognize it immediately.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's wonderfully fruity, on bright, on apricots and peach, but it is immediately joined by some Seville oranges, a tiny bitter orange touch in there, and then there it is. You get these earthy notes, a slightly salty note, some heathery peat in there.
And dare I say, for the people who already guessed it probably by now, for me, as it is from my favorite distillery, this is the classic. It's a nose.
Yeah.
So you have to go back in time a little bit. This is good.
And the smokiness is in the background. It's not dominating at all, but it's very discreet, but so heartwarming.
Like it should.
Oh, beautiful. On the palate then.
There we go.
That body is just great. It's round and rich, and despite the high ABV, it's not burning. Forget water, you do not want to dilute this.
No, not at all.
Well, the typical salty note comes first now, in my opinion, and then it is joined by the smokiness that becomes bigger than the nose promised. The smoke is, what a beautiful development.
It's well balanced.
And then the fruit kicks in.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. But indeed, like you said, this is a very, very balanced single malt.
Yeah.
Oh, is that the sun?
That's the sun.
Is that the sun? The sun's coming out for us. Wonderful. On the finish then. Very long, soothing, and it's in the finish especially that this malt proves again how well balanced it is.
It is. It really is.
Oh wow.
Very happy to have this one.
So Manny and I are very proud to be able to present to you this Orkney malt.
Yeah.
For the fourth and final installment. This is truly a magnificent and worthy conclusion to the Antarctica series. And remember, only 50 bottles, and we're quite sure these are gonna go like
fast.
Oh my god, they'll be gone in minutes.
Yeah.
Anyway, but you can find them at malts.com, and that's all for this whiskey rambling.
Yeah.
And I think we should pour ourselves another one while we say goodbye from these good people.
Right.
So that's all for this whiskey rambling, and we hope to see you at one of Mark's whiskey ramblings real soon. And until then,
the
malt be with you. Bye bye.